Today, we're going to take a quick look at the Temperament Generator and go over some of its features. The Temperament Generator is an application for real-time implementation of microtonal tunings. Essentially, what it does is it takes in a MIDI input and outputs MIDI with precise pitch bend values. The MIDI input I'm using is a MIDI keyboard, and my output is going to this synthesizer. You'll notice that I have target MIDI channel turned on. I'll get to what that means a little bit later on. To start with, it should be clear that nothing really changes. That's because we're working in equal temperament. Equal temperament is defined using a reference pitch and an octave or pseudo-octave. Here I'm using 880 Hz. And that space is divided into 12 equal parts. If you like, you could divide that space into 36 equal steps. Or you could divide a much smaller space into 12 equal steps. When using the temperament generator, there are three modes for us to work with. The first one, equally divided temperaments, we've already covered. The second mode we're going to take a look at is scala. Scala, let me just sort this out. Scala allows us to type in ratios, cents, and integer values to create our temperament. However, the best way for me to demonstrate this is if I just import a scala file. Let's go for this one. When working with scala, we can use the values in the table to distort the structure we have created in the console. Now these intervals will be stretched across a compound fifth. The third mode we're going to take a look at is series. Series allows us to type in mathematical expressions into the console, and packaged with the temperament generator are three presets. The first one, Pythagoras, creates the harmonic series. Before I demonstrate this, however, I'm going to show you a cheeky trick. If you put transpose on, you can change the number in the reference pitch, and the octave will stay the same. Let's make it 110. We also have the Fibonacci preset, which offsets pitches by the golden ratio, and what I named OG. This just produces equal temperament, but it gives you an idea of how this mode works. One of the nice features of this mode is that you can select whether or not you want the series to be ascending or descending. I've now switched back to equal temperament, and the next thing I want to show you is that you can create multiple temperaments all at once. So for this, we're going to create an octave divided equally into 7 parts and an octave divided equally into 6 parts. The last thing I'm going to show you is how to deal with the mapping. You'll notice that in this column, I have multiplier set to 1. All of these structures go through group 1. Group 1 allows me to pick a reference pitch from one of my structures and transpose everything relative to that. For simplicity, I'm just going to go back to equal temperament. So at the minute, everything should still be the same. But if I liked, I could transpose it up a perfect fifth. Or down a perfect fourth. The multiplier extends your temperament to cover the entire 128 MIDI note range. However, in some circumstances, you might not want that to be the case. When the multiplier is turned off, your temperament is organized using group 0. Group 0 has its own reference note. At the minute, it's set to A0. As this temperament has 12 notes in it, I should only get 12 notes when I play the keyboard. When using multiple temperaments, this arrangement allows for great flexibility when organizing your keyboard mapping. The next thing I'm going to take a look at is how to use the temperament generator with contact. This is achieved with one click of a button. What this does is change the output from sending pitch bend values to CC messages. For more information on using microtonality with contact, please see my previous video. Now, let's make a nice temperament. The last thing I want to take a look at is using the temperament generator in Max for Live. Because of the way Live's MIDI channels work, the temperament generator can't be used as a MIDI device. Instead, it needs to be used within a Max instrument. As you can see here, I've included the temp gen in this AMXD, and I sent it this Max for Live 1 message. This tells the temperament generator to accept MIDI from this inlet and output it from this outlet. To make working in Max and Max for Live a little bit easier, I've included a bee patcher and an abstraction with this project. The bee patcher, called MIDI Bay, can be seen here. And what it does is it takes in a MIDI input and organizes your MIDI messages for a poly. When target MIDI channel is turned on, it targets a poly voice based on the incoming MIDI channel. This helps keep things organized, and for best results, you should use this as often as possible. Now when we look inside the poly, you can see that I've got this object here, M2F and C. And what this does, it converts MIDI and pitch bend into frequency and sense. The patch that I've created here is really not very complicated, and instead it's just to show you how to use these objects within Max for Live. So let's just take a look at what it looks like. You can see that when I open the temperament generator, some of the UI controls are missing, and this is because of that Max for Live message. Now, let's make one more temperament before we finish this video.